Happy, happy back to Hogwarts Day, and welcome to our global live streaming celebration of the Wizarding World, presented by the Harry Potter Fan Club. Today, we're not only celebrating back to Hogwarts, but also the 20th anniversary of Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone making its big screen debut and bringing movie magic to millions around the world. My name is Yinka Bikini, and as a lifelong Harry Potter fan, it is my absolute pleasure to be here and join in with the official celebration with you all. Welcome, welcome. Today is September 1st, one of the biggest days in the Wizarding World calendar, marking when students of all ages head back to Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry. Now, there's only one way to get back to Hogwarts, and that is on the Hogwarts Express, which leaves at 11 a.m. sharp from platform 9¾ at King's Cross Station in London. Note, we do not recommend you borrowing a flying car. It's been 20 years since Harry Potter first came to life on screen, and I really can't believe that it's been that long. It feels like yesterday. This film still sparks our imaginations. It tells us to face life with bravery and love, and it shows the true power of friendship. And for me, that's the real magic. From now through November, we'll be celebrating 20 fan-favourite magical moments from Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone, and you are invited to celebrate alongside us every single step of the way. Now, today, we've invited some special guests along for the ride, and we want you to get involved as well. Let us know which house you're returning to this year, and make sure to show us your Hogwarts house pride in the comments. We want to see how you are celebrating by using the hashtags #BackToHogwarts and #20Years of movie magic on social media. You might just see your messages live during our show, so make them good. In fact, let's see what a few of you are already saying. Hello to everyone out there. One's ready from Indonesia. We've got Charlene M, all the way from Indonesia. What house are you from, Charlene? Make sure you're using the hashtag #BackToHogwarts and #20Years of movie magic. We've got Carol K from NYC waiting to head back to Hogwarts, 11 a.m. sharp from platform 9¾. Make sure you remember that and keep your comments coming in and make sure you're using those hashtags. Ruth T said Gryffindor and ready. I think you're in some good company here, Ruth, because we've got a few Gryffindors joining us today. And if you're loving these comments and want to meet friends in the community and you're not already a member of the Harry Potter Fan Club, be sure to visit wizardingworld.com to join our magical community and get sorted into your Hogwarts house and delve deeper into the Wizarding World. Now, whether you saw the film 20 years ago or 20 minutes ago, there is no denying that it is the ultimate silver screen introduction into a world of wizardry and imagination. It's a place where friendship means everything and magic is everywhere. So now, pull up a chair, take a deep breath, and let's celebrate a film and now stage phenomenon that the original Harry Potter book series inspired.
You're a wizard, Harry.
I'm a what? Wingardium Leviosa.
Turn around in the dungeon! Gryffindor!
I think it is clear that we can expect great things from you.
When things seem most dark, it will show him the light.
Vault 687.
Anything off the trolley, dears?
Pumpkin pasty, chocolate frog.
Oopsie-daisy.
Welcome to another year at Hogwarts.
I'm Ron, by the way. From Weasley.
I'm Hermione Granger, Oculus Repairer.
Thank you.
Wasn't that a great way to start? Oh my gosh, I remember seeing Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone at the cinema with my brother, and it was so magical seeing the characters on the big screen for the first time. That was the moment that I knew I was going to be a Harry Potter fan forever, because the film really brought the wonder of Hogwarts to life, and it became a family tradition to watch those films with my little brother. I'd never seen anything like it before. Pure magic. Now, sadly, we don't have any time turners lying around, so we've got to crack on and look forward. We've got some very special guests from the Wizarding World joining us to say hello, and you also need to grab a pencil and paper for our interactive quiz. We'll see how fans around the world are celebrating back to Hogwarts, and of course, we'll even take a trip to platform 9¾. More on that to come. We obviously love the Harry Potter stories, but one of the greatest things about the Wizarding World is, of course, you. And we love it when you show off your creativity online. After all, it is your imagination that makes these stories even more special. Back in 2001, as the first Harry Potter film was released, the internet was just coming into its own. Now, there's a huge global community of all ages, generations, and backgrounds sharing their love of the boy who lived online. Not to mention the fact our phones and computers are a lot fancier 2 decades later. So whether you're sharing your favourite TikTok, creating gorgeous fan art, or upping your cosplay game with your finest Dumbledore beard, we celebrate your creativity. We recently took a look online and found some of the most fabulous fan videos. Let's take a look.
Now, what would 3 Gryffindors be doing inside on a day like this?
Where have you been? You could have died! Of course, I don't blame you, Harry, dear.
It's Leviosa, not Leviosa.
I am ready. I am in my Bulbaton uniform and I'm feeling very fancy.
I am here with the lovely James and Oliver Phelps.
Mr. Longbottom, would you kindly silence your screaming toad?
There is so much creative energy. I'm absolutely obsessed. Thank you to everyone who shared your videos with us. You were all amazing. And speaking of internet sensations, there's actually someone from Harry Potter who's been breaking the internet. Do you know who I'm talking about? We are so chuffed to welcome our next guest, who is very well known in the social media world himself. He's a creator, a musician, and an all-round hilarious guy. And not to mention, he's one of your favourite stars from the Harry Potter film series. Please welcome the one, the only, it's Tom Felton.
Thank you so much. What an intro.
How are you?
I'm very well. I can't believe it. 20 years, but yeah, thanks for having me.
20 years. You look a day over 11. It's great having you here with us today, and thank you so much for hanging out. Now, listen, we love that you're doing your thing on social media. How did it all start for you?
A friend of mine, Muggles, they let me know that there's a few things going on. I'm not really the techno master of the world, but I got into it through various different means of social media, and I've seen the fan flame exist globally, which is a lot of fun.
Yeah, I think it's amazing, and I think that we should check you out in action as a creator. Let's have a look at what you've been up to, Tom.
Listen to me. Do it as I do it. Just say exactly as I do it.
Potter.
It wasn't bad. It should be more of a
Potter.
That's the one. That's the one. That's the one. That's the one. Who can beat that? Who can actually say Potter better than that?
We loved your Potter TikTok challenge. How did I do?
Bloody good.
Was it all right?
It's kind of scarily.
Was it okay? Can you talk us through that? Like, were you surprised at how successful it was?
Yeah, very much so. Yeah, I didn't realise that. A lot of people have asked me to say Potter over the years. I didn't
realize. Can you give us one more?
Potter. That's as far as I can go with it. But it's exciting to see, so many people give it a try from every country around the world and doing a marvellous job at it.
Do people shout it at you in the street?
A little bit.
Are you mad at it? You're not mad at it, are you?
No, they request it more than they shout it at me, so that's better.
That's okay then.
Yeah, I can do it.
Why do you think that Harry Potter has inspired so much creative work, like fantastic creative work online?
It's the best thing about Potter, in my opinion, is that it's just inspired so many people around the world from all ages to read and to create their own content. And yeah, as you see, the net's cast pretty wide.
And do you think that it's you guys as cast? Do you think it's your love for the series?
I don't know. It's a million-dollar question. I think it's the spark of imagination in youngsters, especially. I know it did wonders for my generation. This is the beautiful thing about it is it's being passed down now to the next generation, so.
Well, there are a whole new generation of fans growing up with you as Draco Malfoy in the movies. It makes me curious, did you relate to Draco at all when you were playing him on screen?
Not at all. My parents are very caring and lovely. Luckily, I just looked like the guy, which made it a lot more fun to play, to be fair. but yeah, it is exciting to see the fact that a lot of the fans now weren't even born before the first films were made. So clearly it's something that's being handed down generation to generation, which is cool.
As part of your creative series, we know you're very dear friends with your on-screen father, Jason Isaacs.
Mm.
It must be so fun to stay in touch with your fellow actors as well. It's like a family, I feel like.
Sure.
You've seen like that.
Hi, Dad, if you're watching. No, it is. It's really cool. And ironically, I think I'm one of the glues that sort of keep us all together in a way. Yes, it's an ongoing family. We're often in different places at the same at the same time, but when we get back together, it feels like that we just walked into the Great Hall for the first time, so it's kind of nice.
How would you say, since discovering social media, TikTok, whatever it may be, you have evolved online?
Well, I was thinking about this earlier, and I think in 2001, we were still getting bags of fan mail from all around the world, which was very endearing and very, you know, overwhelming slightly. And it took a long time to really have any sort of correspondence. Now I can sort of speak to anyone, any fan from around the world instantly, and it allows me to sort of keep up with the latest trends and to see what other, you know, creative form the Harry Potter inspiration goes to next.
Well, actually, on that note, it's my time to tell you, make sure you're using those hashtags back to Hogwarts and hashtag 20 years of movie magic to get involved in today's live stream as we count down to the Hogwarts Express taking off. What's next for you online, though, Tom? Do you have any ambitions that you'd like to share, your creative ones?
I don't want to reveal too much, but I have a couple of things up my sleeve. I just say I've enjoyed the interaction with the Potter fans. I can't stop myself now, can I?
But we don't want you to stop.
I can't stop it. I've enjoyed it so much over the last couple of years that I intend to keep doing more and more. And you'll be the first to know as and when I can reveal all.
I got a little wink there, double wink, so I know that it's true. I have to ask, though, you know, as it must have been so amazing on set of the films.
Mm.
What is your favourite memory that you have while you were filming Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone?
It's tough to pick one. It really is. I'll tell you mine if you tell me yours. As far as your first time watching it, mine was the Great Hall, because it was it's a great scene. It was a fantastic set. Never have I seen a set built like that before or since. And we were kept outside purposefully, not to sort of ruin the surprise for us. So yeah, all of our reactions were genuine in that moment. And that kind of started the whole thing off. But yeah, I'm intrigued to know with you and your brother. Do you remember the...
Yeah, it was the revealing of, spoiler alert, Voldemort's head.
Oh, yeah.
Because everyone in the cinema lost their minds. We freaked out a little bit. It was very scary.
Still freaks me out to the day.
It was so good. But thank you so much for joining us, Tom. I feel like,
pleasure.
On behalf of Wizarding World fans all over the world, it's been an honour to chat to you and to have a bit of Potter in our lives. Do you know what I mean?
I do, and I want to say thank you to you, and thank you to all the fans over the last two decades that have kept the fan flame going. We really appreciate it.
I was going to ask you if you have any parting words, but I feel like you just did it very nicely.
I stole it from you, sorry.
Well, thank you, Tom, for joining us in the studio here to celebrate back to Hogwarts Day. It has been incredible to have you on the show. And Tom is not our only guest today. We have got a fun challenge lined up in just a moment with two very special guests who are well-known creators in the Harry Potter fan community. In fact, you may already be a little bit familiar with them. Let's get acquainted with our next studio visitors.
Silence. I will not have you in the course of a single evening besmirching that name by behaving like a babbling, bumbling band of baboons.
We're currently about to walk past the wizarding portraits, which are all very beautiful here at the tour. They're very detailed. I just want to live here, to be honest. Can I come through? Don't test me!
To everyone watching around the world, it is now time for Quick as a Golden Snitch. Two incredible creators from the world of Harry Potter are here to go head-to-head for three interactive challenges. In fact, you saw them earlier. We have got Cherry Wallis here in the studio. Hi, Cherry.
Hello. Happy back to Hogwarts Day. I'm so excited. Also, I feel as though I'm in the Gryffindor common room now, so I feel right at home.
As a Gryffindor, thank you for having me. I'm a Ravenclaw, but I feel good.
You're so welcome here.
Thank you. Thank you. And Cherry, would you describe yourself as a Harry Potter fan? And if so, how much?
I feel like this is a trick question, like you're trying to trick me here, but no, I am probably one of the biggest Harry Potter fans you'll probably ever meet, to be honest.
I think we've got another one, because beaming into the show, we have got Chanel Williams. Hi, Chanel.
Hello, thanks for having me.
How are you, and how have you been celebrating your love for Harry Potter online?
I started doing the Harry Potter impression challenges, and it turned out people were a big fan of my Professor McGonagall. So from there, it's turned into a whole thing. And when people tell me that it's really good, I do have to say, well, thank you for that assessment, Mr. Weasley.
She did it.
I know, it's amazing. It's like Maggie Smith.
Our two star contestants will face three thrilling live challenges and score house points for their favourite Gryffindor house with each correct answer. They'll test their knowledge and courage to the breaking point. And you can actually join in at home. Let's see how much you know about your favourite film. Be sure to post your answers in the comments, and you'll just need a pen or paper, pen and paper or a pencil, and to get your answers in and get your thinking caps switched on as well. Chanel, are you ready?
I'm so ready. Going to do Gryffindor and Professor McGonagall proud.
Cherry, are you ready?
I am so ready. Very excited.
All right. How about everyone playing at home? Are you guys ready? I'm going to take that as a yes. This is your first challenge. I'm going to show you a picture briefly and then ask questions about what was in that picture. This is a test of magical memory and skill. You need to look very, very closely at the image that is about to be on screen. Can we have image number one, please? Ooh. All right, all right. Cherry, here in the studio. What number is on the front of the Hogwarts Express?
Oh, you are testing my knowledge. I want to say 1596, but I think that might be wrong. Take my house point.
1596, is that your final answer?
No, it's 5-2 at the end, isn't it?
How about you at home? The answer is 5972.
Oh, I'm a fake fan.
Oh!
Take my house points away.
Naughty, naughty. Nil pois for Gryffindor there. But don't worry, Cherry, it's still, well, Chanel actually, it's still all to play for. Let's have a look at image number two. All right, Chanel, for 10 huge Gryffindor house points, who is sitting on Ron's lap?
Well, it may look like a common garden rat, but I think that that might be Scabbers / Peter Pettigrew.
Oh, she gave us all of the answers. Yes, ding, 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 it's 10 points for Gryffindor. And for a bonus point, actually, what box of sweets is Scabbers eating on Ron's lap, Chanel?
Might it be a packet of Bertie Bott's Every Flavour Bean?
You are on a run, I tell you. It is a packet of Bertie Bott's Every Flavour Beans. Another 10 points for Gryffindor. And I can tell by your reaction that that was a guess. Well done to both and to everyone playing at home as well. Not bad. We're limbered up. Don't worry, it was a hard question. We're limbered up. Are you both ready for the next challenge? Are you ready at home for the next challenge? Do you have your drawing paper and your pen or pencil ready at home? Because you have got precisely 30 seconds in this drawing extravaganza to draw a scene from Harry Potter's first cinematic adventure. I want to see your rendition of Harry, Ron, and Hermione battling the troll in Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone. Your time starts now. Go, go, go!
Oh, the pressure.
Gryffindors, assemble.
This does not look like a troll.
As me not drawing, this seems like a really long time, but you guys are super intense. Chanel, you're getting the watercolours out.
Oh, we're getting there. I've got all the main characters in here.
Remember, it's Leviosa, not Leviosa.
Oh, they look too happy to be fighting a troll.
Oh! This is quite fun. How are you doing at home?
I'm stressed.
Okay, time is almost up. There you go, ding, ding, ding. I'm going to need you to show your artwork. And Chanel, put your cap on your pen and show us what you have drawn.
It's open to interpretation, and also that orange dot was Ron's hair.
Oh, my troll's way too happy. Everyone's too happy to be around
Cherry.
A troll.
It looks like they're just meeting him.
It's nice to meet you.
These are both very, I'm going to say, interesting artworks. Let's get a close-up of these for all of you at home, and we're going to let you vote on who the winner is of this challenge while we play the final round. Are you Team Cherry or Team Chanel? That is big nostrils.
Hey, I've got Harry's scar.
And how did you get on at home as well? I want to see your artwork. Make sure you're posting them right now. And you might have struggled with that last task because it was a little bit tough, but there is still everything to play for in this fiendishly difficult final challenge. Ooh, are you ready to solve some magical riddles? Yes, I said magical riddles. Did you think it was going to be easy? Of course not. Of course not. This is Hogwarts. For everyone at home, pop those answers in the comments and the very best of luck. This one's for you, Cherry.
Ooh, nervous.
Sing me to sleep, but beware my fearsome three-headed bite. Who am I?
Fluffy.
You are Fluffy. 10 points to Gryffindor! Fluffy, Hagrid's lovely, lovely pet with all of that drool. All right, Chanel at home. Riddle two is for you. Can I just say, if you don't get this right, I'm not sure what's going to happen. Often mistaken for a tabby cat, this Hogwarts animagus is strict and fair. But who am I?
I think if I got this wrong, I could never show my face again. And so, A will she, the day imp, Professor McGonagall.
The only reason we gave you that one was to get the impression out of you once again. Congratulations, another 10 points to Gryffindor. And I think, actually, now it's time to have a look at what you at home think of the artwork that our two artists attempted in the studio. Chinapak K says, oh, I'm terrible at drawing, but are you worse than Cherry? That's the question you need to ask yourself. Because you are the bar, though.
Yeah.
You are the bar, if you think about it. You know what I mean? Make sure you're using the hashtag Back to Hogwarts and hashtag 20 years of movie magic. Cherry is awesome, said Christopher E.
Oh, thank you.
You're not
thank
wrong.
You, Christopher.
You're not wrong at all. Keep those comments coming in. Keep keeping us company. And I think let's see who is the winner of this whole
the pressure's
thing.
On.
We are tallying up the scores. We are counting the house points. And I can reveal that. Chanel, 20 to 10, you are the winner. Congratulations.
Yay.
On an astonishing victory.
Thank you so much. Go, go, Gryffindor.
Well, to be fair, you did score 30 house points, so there you go. An extra thank you to everyone who took part at home. Well done to Cherry as well.
Thank you very much.
You know, you are very gracious.
Thank you.
Yeah, and congratulations to Chanel. What a result. What a brain. And what an absolute expert in the wizarding world. All of us here, salute you. That is some serious Hogwarts prefect energy. And thank you both of you for joining us. For those at home, keep those comments flowing in. You are very important to the Harry Potter fan community, and we cannot wait to see what these guys do next and what you guys do next as well. Let's take a look at who's been watching so far and what they've been posting, shall we? Ooh, make sure you're using the hashtags back to Hogwarts and hashtag 20 years of movie magic, making sure that we can see you. Goldie says, can't wait to get back to Hogwarts after a year of distance learning. I think you are so right, and thank you for all of your messages and your posts. It is great to hear from so many people from all around the world, all corners of the world. Now, everyone is looking forward to heading back to Hogwarts very soon, but if you can't get a ticket, then I've got the next best thing with some brand new tech wizardry. If we can't all be together on the actual platform 9 3/4, then let's bring the magic to you. Through the power of AR, you can have that experience right from your home. Scan the QR code on screen and get ready to step through the wall at King's Cross all on your phone. And remember, best to do it at a bit of a run if you're nervous. Once you've gone through that fateful brick wall, you can even flip the camera around and take a peek around the platform yourself.
Platform 9 3/4, baby. Hello.
And don't forget to be sure to take a selfie and share it with your friends. Wow, wow, wow. Look at this. It's as if I've made it through the wall myself. Don't you think this looks a lot like Platform 9 3/4? And now we're just a few minutes away from that very special Back to Hogwarts moment when the Hogwarts Express departs from Platform 9 3/4 at King's Cross Station for a new term. The moment we've all been looking forward to all morning. And of course, the train will be packed with students new and returning, or in the case of one Neville Longbottom, someone just trying to find their unruly pet toad, Trevor. You have to hang on for just a moment longer, but we are getting ever so close, and we're obviously very excited here in the UK about Back to Hogwarts. But let's not forget what else has been happening around the world. There are millions of Wizarding World fans out there in every country, and big love to all of you watching. All around the globe, fans have been celebrating. Let's have a look now at something special that happened in Paris. As we know, for lots of children, the 1st of September represents the end of the summer holidays, but in the Wizarding World, it's something truly special. It's when we return to Hogwarts, of course. To mark this special occasion in France, a spectacular full-size Hogwarts Express and Platform 9 3/4 appeared at the Gare de Paris Saint-Lazare in the delight of visitors. It was amazing. This magic and fun immersive experience gave fans the chance to get right up close to a huge life-size Hogwarts Express. They also got the chance to have a go at pushing their trolley right through to Platform 9 3/4. I wonder if any of them actually got through. What do you reckon? Getting to take a photo with the train was a great day out, and the chance to create some special memories ahead of the school term starting. Now, one of the things synonymous with going back to Hogwarts is, of course, the sorting hat, and families were treated to an amazing Lego version to pose along with, alongside a very cute Harry Potter figurine. Now, as if that wasn't enough to top off this wizarding experience, the Paris station is hosting an exhibition of illustrations by Mina Lima that tell the story of the magical Harry Potter saga. It is immersive, it is detailed, they've got artworks of Diagon Alley and beautiful, intricate illustrations of Harry and his friends. And look at the clock! I completely lost track of time in Paris. We are nearly ready to depart. Do you have your ticket? Do you have your wand? Is your trunk secure? Because it sounds like the Hogwarts Express is ready to go for a brand new school term. Are you ready? Here we go. This is the moment we have all been waiting for all years long. Get the steam engine ready, because it's time for the Hogwarts Express.
You're a wizard, Harry.
Blimey, is that the time?
Here's your ticket.
This is Platform 9 3/4. There's no such thing.
Is there?
I see you've packed.
See, you haven't.
I can't wait.
See you at Platform 9 3/4.
I get to connect with friends from all over the world.
I'm really looking forward to seeing everybody.
So excited.
Really excited.
I'm ready for another year of Hogwarts.
To experience riding broomsticks.
Walking around, exploring.
I can't wait.
Returning to Hogwarts means everything to me.
That is magic.
May I have your attention, please? The Hogwarts Express is now departing from platform 9 3/4.
Come on now, first years, don't be shy.
How am I doing my first day?
Brilliant.
Help will always be given at Hogwarts to those who deserve it.
You have friends here.
You're not alone.
Welcome to another year at Hogwarts.
I'm excited to head back to Hogwarts this year.
Back to our home away from home, where we are free to be our naturally magical selves.
Anything off the trolley, dears?
Floating bonbons, because they're delicious.
Might also like the every flavored beans, but I have a couple of bad experiences with them.
George swear he got a bogey flavored one once.
I want to join the Quidditch team. I have my goggles.
The most exciting thing, magical creatures class.
Super exciting to be able to explore those grand halls again.
There we go. Now I feel like a proper Hogwarts student.
Show my new plant off.
Welcome back to Hogwarts.
Are you excited?
You can always make new friends.
Can't wait to see you.
Hogwarts will always be there to welcome you home.
Wicked.
Now while you're here, your house will be like your family.
I can't believe it. We are officially on our way back to Hogwarts, everyone. What an incredible way that was to celebrate with all of our wonderful Harry Potter fans across the whole world. And those lovely witches and wizards we got to meet on the Hogwarts Express are just a few of the millions of fans we know are watching right now all over the world. Let's check in to see who else is on their way to Hogwarts, shall we? Make sure you're using the hashtag back to Hogwarts, hashtag 20 years of movie magic. A Hufflepuff dad sending off his daughter to her first year. She's hoping for Slytherin. Oh, Tony, tell her no. Tell her no, Tony. Keep your comments coming in. This is such an exciting day. And we have got hashtag back to Hogwarts. It's an amazing sitting at home, but feeling the magic through your own walls. Lucy, do you know what? You are not wrong. Even though all of us can't technically fit on platform 9 3/4, I'm happy to be here and I'm happy to do this with you. Bailey said that they've cried 3 times already. They're so happy. I'm gonna magic you a tissue. I promise I'll magic you a tissue because we are one huge Wizarding World family and it's so exciting to get to celebrate with all of you today. I am so excited to be here and as a huge fan myself, I'm sure I'm not the only one who has visited King's Cross Station and wished that I could just jump on the Hogwarts Express for real. And, oh, what is that I'm hearing? The train is taking a pit stop on its way to Hogsmeade. Well, I never... In all seriousness, you can always find yourself on the actual Hogwarts Express movie set at Warner Brothers Studio Tour London, just north of London at Leavesden Studios. This is where the Harry Potter films were actually filmed. As one of the most popular tourist destinations in Britain, the tour is home to sets, to props and costumes from behind the scenes of the Harry Potter film series. This has nothing on it. And can I just say that I've been to the tour. It was spectacular, although I definitely took an unhealthy amount of Hogwarts selfies and I'm not mad at it. And earlier, we surprised a few special families with an up-close look at the Hogwarts Express itself. Let's see what they got up to.
Hello and a very happy Back to Hogwarts Day. We're here at Leavesden Studio, the home of Warner Brothers Studio Tour London, the making of Harry Potter. And for 10 years, the cast and crew of the Harry Potter films called Leavesden home. When they wrapped on the Deathly Hallows Part 2, the studio was left with some astonishing artifacts that wouldn't normally be saved after filming. And now, 20 years after the release of the first movie, you can get behind the scenes of the magic and see some of the iconic sets, and none of them are more unique than the Hogwarts Express. And we are very lucky today to have two families of Harry Potter superfans with us who have never seen the Hogwarts Express before.
That's actually really cool.
Whoa.
There it is, guys, that famous train.
So excited.
Being here in front of the iconic Hogwarts Express, how does it feel?
It just reminds me of my childhood.
And it's obviously 20 years since the release of the first film. Do you remember when you saw it?
I went to the cinema with my friend and it became like a thing. We watched every Harry Potter movie together.
Well, very exciting to be here, of course. And we're very lucky to have one of the interactors here from the Warner Brothers Studio Tour London. She is an expert on all things Harry Potter. Hi, Rianne.
Hi, hi, everyone. Welcome. We are on the platform 9¾ set. We are standing right next to the original Hogwarts Express train used in the films. It was an actual working train. It was called the Alton Hall. Once we painted it red for the films, we began filming in a train station in London. Can you guess which one?
King's Cross.
It was King's Cross, you are right. Obviously big Harry Potter fans there. One character that had a little issue when she got to King's Cross was Julie Walters, who played Mrs. Weasley. They'd padded out her costume using birdseed. She was chased by pigeons all the way from the top end of the platform right to the bottom. If you have a look at the train, you'll see it looks really, really narrow, that aisle going down the centre. You can't get a camera crew in there. When they filmed inside the train, they used a set just like that one over there.
This is the Rune Star.
This is so comfy.
How did you build the set?
We had to build a track to slide the train into position in the studios, then build the entire set and the soundstage around it.
It's a lot of work.
It is a lot of work. It was a whole mission.
Is that the green screen?
Yeah, you're right. That is the green screen. Many things would have come up on the green screen, including the Dementors. The actors would have had to pretend that it's really cold in the carriage because that is what they would have seen out of the window.
Is this so fun?
It is fun.
You guys are obviously Harry Potter super fans. How much are you looking forward to passing it on to the kids when they're old enough?
It's a classic, isn't it? How can you not want to pass it down? Definitely looking forward to like Christmases, sat around watching, you know, watching all the movies.
There is one thing I would like you all to help me with before we go. Should we officially send this steam train off to Hogsmeade? Okay, so I'm gonna count you down, and on three, we are gonna say all aboard. Are you ready?
Yeah.
One, two, three.
All aboard!
Thank you very much, guys. That was absolutely fantastic. And from all of us here at the Platform 9¾ set at Warner Brothers Studio Tour London, wishing you a very, very happy Back to Hogwarts Day. See you soon.
Big, big thanks to everyone at Warner Brothers Studio Tour London for showing us around. And if you haven't already visited, book your tickets online. Now, we mustn't forget that along with Back to Hogwarts Day, we're also celebrating the start of a very special 20th anniversary season. My big question for you all is, do you remember seeing Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone for the first time? And then I want to know, where did you see it? And with who? Lots of stuff to write, but let us know in the comments. We want to hear from you, and be sure to use hashtag Back to Hogwarts and hashtag 20 years of movie magic so that I can see you and I can see you properly. Ravina says, you're a wizard, Harry, and then nothing remained the same. Do you know, I think you and millions of us all agree with that sentiment. Nothing was the same once we met the boy who lived. Who else has been getting involved today? My favourite scene were the small boats sailing. Oh, were the first years. Ruth, I kind of forgot about that. The first time we got to see Hogwarts Castle just in all of its glory across the Black Lake. If I start reminiscing now, I'm not going to stop. I'm not going to stop at all. Make sure you use hashtag Back to Hogwarts to get your comments in. We have got, I remember when I saw Harry Potter for the first time 20 years ago. I love it, and I'll always be a Gryffindor. Ooh, Baron. I am outnumbered by the amount of Gryffindors that are here today. If there are any Ravenclaws in the comments, can you come through and let me know? Because I'm feeling a little bit alone. We've got a message from Claire who said, so exciting, feeling nostalgia from when I was younger. Well, make sure you take that excitement and you pass it on to the next generation. I think that is so important. And it has been 20 years since the movie first came out in cinemas, and that is where the Harry Potter on-screen magic began for millions of people. It's a special film, and that means such a lot to me. And just seeing it on telly takes me back to when I saw it for the first time, with all of those memories flooding back, and I know I'm not the only one who feels this way. Now, there are a whole new generation of fans who are seeing this film thanks to their parents, and even some kids who have introduced it to their parents. And it's one of those movies that will always have a special place in everyone's heart, whatever age they were when they first saw it. I'm sure all of you watching know exactly what I mean. It's a shared experience for millions of us. Let's hear more about seeing the Philosopher's Stone for the very first time and passing that magic onto a new generation.
I love Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone.
It was the start of something massive.
I remember going to one of the previews with my mum and dad.
And I remember where we sat, what we ate. Sweet popcorn.
I love to be drawn into this world.
Wow, 20 years.
Still, like, one of my favourite films.
It's part of my childhood.
Being a young kid, you just wanted to be part of that universe.
Brought to life what we had imagined.
Seeing them head to Hogwarts for the very first time just makes me smile.
My little girl, she's 9, and I'd love to pass the wand on to her.
So special, we can all watch something together.
All of these magical things, you get to see that visual for the first time.
I was immediately hooked.
The joy and the love for Harry Potter became an unhealthy obsession.
I loved it, and now she loves it. It's nice to share it.
We're going to watch it again tonight when we go home, aren't we?
It's the original, it's the first. Something that is just great to be able to pass down mother to daughter.
Makes me really emotional.
It's about loyalty and friendship. It teaches about how you deal with life's problems.
Really good things to instill in children.
Specto Patronum.
Expelliarmus.
Guardian Leviosa.
We're still obsessed with it, and we're in our 30s.
Huge thanks to all the fans for allowing us to visit your pensives and sharing those memories. And do you remember when I asked you earlier to share your messages with us? Well, we've gotten loads of lovely notes from you all, plus some photos of how you're celebrating back to Hogwarts at home. Let's check out some of the comments that are coming in during our live stream. Oh, okay, Harry Potter is the best. Sending love to all of the wizards and witches of all the houses from Isabel. Sending love to you as well, wherever you are watching from, Isabel. And actually, let me know where you are watching from, what corner of the world that you're in. Who is this? This is Kelowna. Can't believe it's been 20 years. The Harry Potter series is the best series in the entire world. And it feels like going home when I rewatch it again. Do you know, just being here today and being on platform 9¾, I might go home and I might rewatch Harry Potter today. I'm still waiting for my letter to Hogwarts, aren't we all, for 20 years. Oh, and I hope to be called to the House of Ravenclaw. Lewis, we will welcome you with open arms. Open arms, Lewis. Come over to the wise Ravenclaws. And hashtag back to Hogwarts. Can't wait to catch the train back home. Hopefully home means Hogwarts because the term's just started, Chloe. Hopefully. I think we're on the same page. We must be. Hashtag back to Hogwarts and hashtag 20 years of movie magic like Pinky did. Hello from Connecticut. Love all things Harry Potter and we love you as well, Pinky. And we have got some pictures coming through as well. Who's this? This is Kelly, who is a Gryffindor, and we just love to see that house pride. And I think you might have a potted mandrake behind you, Kelly. So be sure to cover your ears. Maybe it's not a mandrake, but I just love that unintentional reference anyway. Up next, we have got Danil. They're also a Gryffindor, and I'm just digging those cozy vibes you've got going on in the back. It looks like you're even bringing a little bit of the spirit of the Great Hall into your home, which we love to see here. We love to see it. Who's this? We've got Zach, and he is a Slytherin, and also, oh, a Quibbler reader. What's the latest goss, Zach? And might I have those specs looking mighty sharp on you, my friend? We've got another Gryffindor photo here. It's Nicolette, who is adorable in her beautiful Harry Potter home. And can I just say, that embroidery on your collar is stunning. And it appears that a Harry Potter movie marathon is in your future. I'm jealous. This is Sawyer and Eve, who are Hufflepuff and Slytherin. I tell you what, guys, I bring the popcorn, you bring the movies, and we have ourselves a marathon. And next up, this is the cheekiest. It's Alex and Ben. Now, they are looking very ready for going back to Hogwarts with their wand and their robes and their scars and their glasses and everything. And we've finally been sent this lovely photo from Louisa. What a fab little Hogwarts student you are with your hat and your wand and your desk. Definitely a Hufflepuff. Thank you so much for getting involved. And you know what? It's just great to come together today and celebrate Back to Hogwarts as one big Wizarding World family. Your comments are so wonderful to hear. And if you can't tell, it puts a big smile on my face reading them. And well done to you for creating those incredible moments and incredible photos and incredible memories. A thank you to everyone who posted something and got involved. You were all amazing, and this is an honour. It's been wicked to spend time with you, and from that emotional moment when we saw Hogwarts for the very first time to now, as we begin a whole new adventure, it just shows how far we've all come and how much more, I think, there is to discover. It's brilliant to know that we can all come together as one big magical family and just enjoy being ourselves and living our best Wizarding World lives. And it's been an absolute pleasure and a privilege, because together we celebrated Back to Hogwarts. 20 years of movie magic, and you even heard from our incredible Harry Potter fan community. Of course, I have to thank Tom Felton again for joining us in this global celebration, and to our amazing creators, Chanel and Cherry too. Now, we invite you to head over to wizardingworld.com, where you can stay up to date with even more celebrations in the coming weeks as we remember every part of Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone, the beginning of our wizarding journey. At wizardingworld.com, you can also sign up for the Harry Potter fan club, where you will officially get sorted into your Hogwarts house. And as a fan club member, you can look forward to getting the latest news and more from across the Wizarding World. Now, if you happened to have missed anything from today, then the whole show will be posted on the Wizarding World YouTube channel. And while you're at it, remember what makes the movie so special by watching Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone again, and share the magic for the first time with your friends and your family. Give them the gift of magic. And we know that you don't need an excuse as well for a cheeky rewatch. So let the magic begin, and there you have it. 20 years of movie magic and 20 magical moments to explore. And the Hogwarts Express is only just set off. But for now, all that's left to do from me is to wish you a happy Back to Hogwarts Day.